gang, it's your boy Armand Lindsay back with another vlog or review, whatever you want to call it, man. But just here recently, probably about a week ago, I just got the new, well, not really new, but for me it's new, DJI Mavic 3 Classic. Prior to the DJI Mavic 3 Classic, I had a DJI Mini Pro drone and I ended up wrecking it in New Orleans. So I've been, I was pretty pissed about that. And so like the next day I ended up ordering the DJI Mavic 3 just because I ain't wanna be too long without a drone. I gotta have the drone, the aerial footage. It's just, you gotta have it. It's something in your toolbox. But once I got it, obviously I had to do, you know, flight testing and things like that. So from the clips that you just saw earlier, you know, that was just me flying, you know, within the city. Obviously great color grading, great, you know, the quality on it was great, but I'm just gonna kind of give you a few things that I like, and maybe a few things that I dislike, things that I liked about the DJI Mini Pro, that I would, if I was DJI, I would look to implement in some of the newer drones. But yeah, let's get into it. So I took some notes, put it down on my phone. So what I like, obviously, the new camera sensor. It's a bigger sensor, so which makes the footage, as you can see, a lot more clearer, a lot better. And you could just, you could push that footage to the limit. What a lot of people don't know. I was surprised when putting it on Final Cut Pro, like how far I could really push the footage and how much detail I could really get out of it. The dynamic range on the footage was insane. From not only from the new camera sensor, we have the next thing I had was pushing the color grade. So obviously that goes back to the dynamic range. The footage that you saw was shot in no particular profile, like that's straight out of the drone. I didn't change it to the D-Log footage, like that's strictly out of the drone. So but I color graded it and amplified the colors in the footage. As you can see, I'll show you like from what it came out as and then obviously the colors that I was able to push and amplify in the footage. So I'll show you both versions of those, which is it's insane, like the way you could tweak it. Because usually one of the things that about the DJI Mini Pro series is that the footage that you get is kind of what you get. Like you can't really push it to a whole nother level to get, you know, it doesn't have that much dynamic range, and it's really just baked in. But on the DJI Mavic Classic, Mavic 3 Classic, phenomenal, phenomenal dynamic range. Another thing is 46-minute flight time. It's a longer flight time, so it gives you more time in the air. I love it, because sometimes I don't know, when I'm in the air, I don't really have a vision of what I'm trying to capture. So me just kind of flying around, seeing what's cool, what'll work, what won't work, having that extra, you know, 10 to 13 minutes is crucial, because it just gives you more time in the air. You can fly a longer distance, so you can go further without losing the connection. That's a, you know, you gotta have it. Like going further is great, just depending on where you are. I would love to go to the beach, take this to the beach somewhere, take it out in the water, see how far we can go. Yeah, I don't know where I would really take it. I want to go, I've been to LA. I took the DJI Mini Pro Series to LA and got some great footage. So I can imagine like taking the Classic to LA, but I want to go like Miami or, you know, get some shots on the water or whatever with the boats and stuff. So I think that'll be pretty cool. Obviously, it's bigger too. So here it is, like large. This was a shock to me, because if I put it by my face, it's just as big as my head. And, you know, my head is a decent size. But yeah, that's the drone right there. So it's a pretty big drone. And then obviously going from the DJI Mini Pro series, I didn't have the remote with the built-in screen. I used my phone. Now there's pros and cons to you having this, the built-in screen, and using your phone. The pro with the phone is that you have internet coming from your phone. You don't have to be hooked up to any type of Wi-Fi for any type of updates or anything like that, or approve any type of Like if you're in an unauthorized zone, you don't have to approve anything because you don't have that that Wi-Fi. But this right here, I love this because it's a bigger screen, it looks better, and it's an easier setup time too. So like I don't have to clip my phone, big old phone, clip it in. You know, this is ready in minutes. I just hit the power button on both and they automatically sync together. So like having this is a game changer for me. Going towards that DJI Mavic 3 Classic. So I would tell anybody, if you don't have this, get the RC remote. And I can't speak on it enough. One of the last notes I had was picture quality, !!! Like the picture quality is gonna be fantastic. So to whomever gets this drone or has been thinking about getting a drone, you won't be upset, especially if you're coming from you know, the DJI Mini Pro series. A few things that I dislike. One, it's not really a big deal, but the size, right? The if I could have the same specs but in that smaller DJI Mini Pro body, that'd be great, because I can travel with that. It doesn't take all the space in my carrying bag. My Mini Pro could go anywhere. Like I could just slide it in there and we good to go. Like it doesn't take up much space at all. Another dislike that I wish they could think about adding is the vertical shooting. You just can't shoot vertical. At least I don't know of a way to shoot vertical. It only does horizontal footage, and so that's just, it is what it is. But if there was a way to just rotate that camera to vertical, better for, you know, TikToks, better for Instagram Reels, I mean, that would be another game changer that I would implement. So if anybody from DJI comes across this video, that's the only thing I would add, is just put the vertical shooting in all the cameras. Like everybody's going vertical, so it just doesn't seem, there's no good reason why it wouldn't be able to go vertical, if that makes sense. But for the most part, this is a quick video. This is kind of just my likes and dislikes of the DJI Mavic 3 Classic. Obviously, you can purchase it yourself, check it out for yourself. But as you can see from the footage from the video, it's like that for sure. And then, and for the price, it's not bad. It's not badly priced. It's less expensive than the DJI Mavic 3, just the 3. This is the DJI Mavic 3 Classic. So the Classic, price wise, is phenomenal. So, you know, check it out. Leave a comment underneath if you got any questions. I'll do some more reviews. If there's any other tech you see or you see me use and you want reviews on it, just let me know. And we'll get those reviews to you. But peace.